the first Screw Tapes, before there was rapping, was just music. You would go to Screw's house, say for $10 you could buy a tape. For $12, he would shout you out on a tape. And I think for like maybe $15 to $20, you could actually get on the mic and shout your hood out. And eventually it turned into some tapes being just all freestyles.
He had people freestyle on the tapes. That gave them an opportunity to shine. That gave them an opportunity to talk about who they were, where they were from, the streets that they drove down. All these different things came alive on their tapes. Some of the first ones were Fat Pat, ESG, C-Note, Big Pokey.
And before you know it, we just kind of said, screwed up click. It was just a bunch of cats from the South Side. And see, we just all be in Screw House and we were in there pretty much freestyling this stuff off the top of the head. But we just talking about stuff that we do on the regular every day. And everybody in the city can relate to it.
The whole Screw culture was based upon the life that we were looking at outside. The cars, the parks, the slab kings.
A slab is a car that you build from the ground up. You get a car, no motor, no nothing. You resurrect a car from the dead.
Different hoods rode different colors. Botany Boys rode candy black. Yellowstone rode candy gold. My partners from Elm Tree rode candy blue.
The rims, we call them swingers, or pokers, or fofos, 84s. Being hood, we don't say fours, we say foes. We don't ride on swingers, we ride on swingers.